Hi, I'm Jared with Fun Science Demos. You know, a classic STEM challenge has always been taking a piece of aluminum foil and seeing if you could design and create a boat, and then seeing how much weight that boat can hold before it sinks. Now, you could use pennies, you could use marbles, you could use paper clips, and then you would just simply keep adding paper clips or pennies or marbles to your boat, keeping track by counting until your boat eventually sinks. You can see my boat's doing a pretty good job. It's almost ready to sink. Let's go. Boom. Now the problem with that STEM activity is that there's really not a lot of design that goes into making the boat. You would just take a piece of aluminum foil and try and sculpt it into something that might actually hold paper clips or pennies or marbles. And usually you get something that looks like a crumbled mess. So we wanted to set out and see if we could design a very specific boat in different shapes and different sizes and improve this aluminum foil boat activity. Engineers who design and build boats use a lot of science and math, and we wanted to bring some of that science and math to our aluminum foil boat activity. Now for this STEM activity, we recommend using heavy-duty aluminum foil. Then really all you need is a ruler and a pencil, but in this case we're going to use a marker so it shows up better so that you can see. I'm going to start by taking my piece of aluminum foil and thinking about a shape that I want to draw for the bottom of my boat. I'm just going to use a rectangle to make it nice and simple. So we've zoomed in so you can get a better look at how we're going to design our boat. We want to start by thinking of a shape that I want my boat to be, and then I want to center that shape on the piece of aluminum foil. So I'm going to use a ruler and I'm going to draw a rectangle. So I'm going to start at 0, I'm going to go to 10 centimeters, I'm just going to draw a nice line. Now I'm going to start spinning my paper, my aluminum foil, and I'll do a 10 centimeter by 8 centimeter rectangle. 8 on that side. Let's go to 8 on this side. And then our final line. If I'm using a pencil, you want to make sure that the sharp point doesn't tear the aluminum foil. Now, this is going to be the shape of the bottom of my boat. So I'm going to line my ruler up with one edge of my boat, and all I'm going to do now is just trace a line on the other side of my ruler. It doesn't matter how long that line is. In fact, I like to extend the lines as long as possible. So I'm just going to go around my rectangle, tracing the outside of the ruler. So now I'm creating another line that's parallel to the inside line. Take your time, make sure everything's lined up and nice and parallel. One more to go. And now you can see I have a larger rectangle outside of my inner rectangle. Now it's time to do some trimming with my scissors. And all I'm going to do is cut the outer rectangle of my boat. I do not want to cut the inside rectangle. So I'm going to take my time, cut along my lines. It's a little flimsy, so take your time and cut on the line. Now it's time to fold the boat and finish it out. To do that, we've zoomed in so you can get a better look, and this is the trickiest spot. I've done this with my own classroom, and this is usually where the kids struggle just a little bit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be folding this outer edge until it lines up with the inner edge. And you want to take your time, and once it's matched up, then you go back over and put a nice, clean, crisp crease right in the aluminum foil. And I'm going to continue all around my rectangle, folding the outer edge until it lines up with the inner edge. Rotate it, outer edge, line it up with the inner edge. Then one more, lining up the outer edge with the inner edge. I'm good to go. So this thin strip all around my rectangle is going to be the side of my boat. Now, I have found to fold up the side, I'm actually going to make a crease and then fold it back down flat so I can fold my edges all around the boat. So I want to fold right on the inner line there of that rectangle. I'm going to fold it up and I'm going to put a nice crease and I'm going to unfold it. And I'm going to work around the boat, folding on that line, putting a crease and unfolding it. Taking my time. A nice crease, unfold it one more to go. And that crease is going to help me form the boat. So now I have all of my sides creased, and now it's time to bring those sides up. This is also another tricky spot, because at this corner, you're going to want to put a little fold, a little angle fold, and you'll see that the sides just naturally come up, and I have this little tab for a corner. I'm going to repeat that all the way around my boat. Put a little angle fold on the corner, fold my two edges up, put a little angle fold on the corner, just by pinching, bring my corners up, last corner, pinch the corner, do a little tugging and pulling to flatten my boat. You're going to notice I have a boat with little tabs in the corners. I have one more step to go, almost there. Now the last step is to fold these little tabs and tuck them around the corner. And usually they want to go one direction. So it looks like this tab is going to want to fold into this side. So I just bend it. This tab right here looks like it wants to go this direction. So tuck it on the side. The nice thing about this aluminum foil is it holds its shape after you fold it. And one more tab to go. I'm going to take it this way. And now I have a beautifully formed rectangular boat. Now the beautiful part of this design process is that I can measure the exact size of the bottom of my boat. I know it's 10 centimeters by 8 centimeters, so that gives me a surface area of 80 square centimeters. And that's going to be important when we talk about the math part of this STEM challenge in our next video. It's time to test out our boat design. Now I have a nice container. You might want to, if you're doing this in a classroom or in your kitchen, just pick up a cheap Tupperware plastic container. Any container would work. We're going to go with this one. So how I drop in the paper clips are important. I don't want to put them all in one corner or one side so my boat tips. I want to kind of try and spread them out evenly. I'm just going to pile them in. You certainly would want to count, but I want to see how many paper clips my boat is going to hold. The neat thing about this is you can start to see the boat sink lower into the water. If you notice that the boat is tipping to one corner, I'm just going to add paper clips to the opposite corner to keep it balanced and level. Surprisingly, this is holding a lot of paper clips. I think we have pretty nice design for our boat. It's starting to sink lower into the water now. She's ready to go. Let's try adding another one. A few more. There's so much more we can do with this aluminum foil boat challenge, and that's what we're going to feature in upcoming videos. I wonder if different shape boats hold more weight. I wonder if different size boats hold more weight. If you want to learn more about STEM challenges, check out our YouTube channel, Fun Science Demos. Science is so cool, even when stuff sinks. Thanks for watching.